I can go to hell for what? For what? For you cleaning up your own puke like a big boy?
Do you know why I did this? It was for fucking money for our family.
Look at his
and
feet.
You want to spend
you
it?
You didn't help a bit with anything.
Oh, really?
Yep.
I didn't help a bit with anything.
Ew.
Yeah, I'm a piece of shit, right?
Off and die. Everybody can die. I mean it.
Yeah.
You realize the fucking pain I was in. No, you don't care either. You never care about how I feel. And that's true.
That is
it's
true.
It's okay, though. I still love the people in my life. I love you. And I will deal with it. Fucking deal with it. You give a fuck.
I don't know who's the worst. Is it Shanny or is it Rev? They hide behind God to do their dry begging. It ain't even dry begging. They just simply point blank ask.
$2 a vomit.
Why is she shaking her frickin' head? Let's look at her eyes, guys. Look at her pupils. This girl is higher than a damn kite, and it's not with weed. It's opiates, you guys. Just so you know, they abuse opiates and benzodiazepines, which is like Valium, Xanax, stuff like that. Lorazepam, diazepam, Alprazolam. All that shit, and they abuse it. See, she agrees.
I'm going downstairs and I'm having me some fucking concentrated. Because I can love it, so.
You think
well
of
earned,
only yourself, Shanny, and you know it.
Well earned.
Rev isn't innocent either, but you think of yourself. You sit there and eat food in front of the guy and let him starve. That's disgusting behavior. I don't like either one of you, but that's still wrong.
Wow, you earned that.
That is not a weed eye. That is not a weed eye. That is an opiate and benzo high. Mixed with weed. But yeah, I shout out Shanny for Christ. Let's see. Soundophone parody. Yeah. So go check that person's videos out. I'm sure they're good. Look at her. What happened? Because she wasn't this big a few years ago. She was big, but not this big.
I hope he washes my clothes. I really do hope he washes my clothes.
Do you wash your clothes ever, Shanny? You could take that damn thing off that you're wearing. It's going to stand up by itself. I don't think you even wash your hair, honestly.
You know what, honey? I've been doing and working my ass off. Doing the best I can. And you've been
what,
nothing but
begging?
A miserable jerk
you have
to
not
everyone.
Worked. Have
what
you
am
ever
I,
had
what
a job?
What am I doing?
Raising, so that's good.
Yeah, I've earned quite a bit of money today.
That's good. Good for you.
For the family.
Well, I earned $10, and I probably had a heart attack from it, because my whole body went numb.
Shut up,
I don't
Rev.
Think you'd be moving and smoking
but
cigarettes
I mean,
if you
I
had a heart attack.
I didn't mess up, did I? Yes, I did.
Yes, you did. And can you clean up my clothes?
When I'm ready.
I like to hear him talk back to her, because she thinks she could boss him around. What is that face, Shanny? Don't do that. Please don't do that. Sorry, I had to mute that. My little girl's trying to come out here and stay awake. It's not happening.
Well, thank God that my husband's going to be okay.
Sorry, you guys, my daughter is just not listening. You're gonna be grounded. I'm gonna take all your electronics. You need to go to sleep. Sorry, you guys. Is this even worth reacting to? I mean, God, all she's doing is shaking her damn head and bitching. That's what she does every dang freaking video. I'm doing this for you guys. I don't watch her content. I seen a video the other day, though. I decided not to go live and react to it because it was one of her kids' bed, and it literally looked like she dug it out of a landfill and threw it in the kid's room.
Yeah, and you told me to die how many times during the process of feeling pain?
Yeah, and what have you said to him?
Really, that's how most people handle it, is they in pain, is they tell people to die.
Oh, just get away from me. It's like, I hurt so bad, just please either help me or leave.
I was trying to help you, but you kept fucking telling me to die, Jason.
Well, helping me isn't safe.
Give it up, Shanny.
But you're lucky I didn't die. I'm here on the...
Oh, yeah, it's my fault you actually took that challenge.
No, I asked for help and nothing comes.
Damn, I'm trying to get every drip.
I did absolutely nothing to try to help you at all.
I didn't say that.
You know what?
Yogurt.
Fuck our relationship. You obviously don't fucking care about it ever.
Yeah, I agree. Walk out. Where are you going? It's like you can't move very far, Shanny.
Shanny, all you care about is your damn self.
Okay, fine. Yeah, go smoke more weed that we don't have, and I won't have anything to smoke. That happens quite a bit. Okay.
What is all that junk back there?
Issue.
This is a little area. It's cluttered, right. But it's not like super dirty that I can see anyways. So what, they stay in one little spot where you can't see much of the dirt?
But I don't know if she hit stop, guys, but I'll be with you in a second. I'm cleaning up my vomit and the clothes.
One more. This is almost over, and then I can react to something else.
Like I said, the plastic bag, or the plastic bin. We'll ask William about it. Anyway, back to you.
Oh, yeah, no focusing on back shit, to you. But focusing
we're,
on...
We're in the middle of cleaning and packing and all that wonderful stuff, because we'll be most fun anyway. So this like, background of this beautiful... That's extremely important to us. We got that at the homeless shelter. But anyway.
Would it have been that hard to buy a damn curtain? Like, why are we using a blanket someone made as a curtain? I hate that. That drives me nuts.
Jason, you need to come in here. You need to talk time that we, like, communicate or something. Because I'm just going to say it. I miss you. I miss you, brother. Horribly, horribly.
When did Shanny get a southern accent? Hey, Jason, you better get your butt in here right now, or I'm going to send you back to your mama's and you're going to get a spanking. That's right. You better get your butt in here, Jason. What the fuck is that? That's the craziest thing I've ever heard.
I'm rolling my hair. I horribly miss you.
and your videos. You're like, you took my Jason fix away, okay, Jason? Let me just let you know.
Her Jason fix. Oh, my God. This is so desperate. Desperado, Shannon. Give it up.
So, when I first came to Christ, I was literally watching every single video that you ever made because you helped me strengthen as a Christian. You were, like, one of the first Christians I ever listened to on YouTube. Like, legitimately listened. I'm not, like, talking about, like, I was an atheist and was, like, mocking the Christian. No, I mean, you were legitimately one of the first Christians I listened to. So I owe you for my growth in Christ because you taught me a lot. I thank you for that because I need you. I need you, brother.
Yeah, brother, she needs you. She needs you and that $700,000 that you just got in your inheritance from your mama. Sorry about that, but could you send some of that my way? Thank you.
Of course, he's gonna.
Hey, okay, get your butt in here. Come on, Jason. Come on. Come on, Jason. You need to come in. I don't have much to do right now. Don't make me get ugly with you. I will get ugly with you. I will be like, Jason, you didn't come in here. You've been ignoring your sister. And don't say you're not in line, mister, because I know your room right now. You're gonna keep getting invited. Because, you know, you're the guest of honor. And I miss you. And I need to talk to my brother. And you know what? I've tried to get a hold of you at PMs. I tried to get a hold of you at Skype. I tried to get you a hold of you on your channel. I tried to get a hold of you on all these different ways. And you've been just ignoring me, and then you like leave me these messages. I'm not ignoring you, I've just been really busy. Well, get out an audience room and talk to your sister.
Okay, first of all, if I was Skyping, calling, DMing, messaging a man and he wasn't responding, I would never ever contact that man again. My mama raised me right. You don't call boys first, they call you. Exactly. Secondly, this is as desperate as it comes. Like, how many ways did you try to contact him, Shannon? Maybe he was dealing with the death of his mother. Maybe he was doing other things. I'm pretty sure he had a girlfriend at this time, but did you respect that? Of course not, because you're you.
Your sister needs you. Now, granted, Jason.
Yeah, Jason, your sister needs you. Why is she referring to herself as his sister? I get it's in Christ and all, but isn't that kind of creepy considering you want to suck his baby carrot?
I know.
Baby carrot cake.
I don't know. What is going on with
baby
you?
Baby carrot cake.
I don't know anything. But I need you. I need you, because I'm like, you were like my elder, and now it's like, I'm like a Christian without an elder.
I'm sure there's plenty of other Christians she could have found, especially online, that would have been her elder. She just wanted Jason because she knew Jason had a lot of money and she was broke.
Where am I? I need you, Jason. I need you. So, you know, maybe you'd come in here, speak a little to me, love me a little, that sort of thing, that wonderful, beautiful thing that should be happening between brother and sister, you know?
Is anyone as creeped out as I am at that she keeps referring to him as her brother? It's so gross, because we all know what her motive here was.
The start of Romans 16, you know what I'm talking about, brother?
Why am I not allowed
come on.
To get
where are you? Done calling you out. I know you were in the audience room. Come on, Jason.
Shut the fuck up.
Oh, how would you know he was in Nadia's room if you weren't stalking the hell out of him? God, you're so creepy, Shannon.
He is.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get a hold of you on this part right here. That's like, Rev. Yep, you're going to get this, and you're going to be like, come into this room now. I'm calling your ass out. So, yeah.
Desperado.
Well, that is so much not true. I know you're in hangout. I can see you live on Nadia's hangout. I know you're on there. You're quiet at the moment, but I can certainly pick you up and be like, yup, he is online. So you need to get your butt in here because your sister needs to talk to you.
I just can't get over this southern accent, y'all. I don't know what she's doing. It doesn't even make any sense. Like, you're from Minnesota, bitch.
Seriously. I need my Jason. What is your sister going to do without her Jason? You know, I need people for certain reasons. I need Rand Campbell because he's a beautiful, lovable man who I just want to hug. And one day, Rand Campbell, me and you, we're going to get our hug on. Yes, we will.
You are
I need my G-Man because he's an awesome brother.
Oh, I have a whole video of Shani calling G-Man her boyfriend, and we'll do that another time. Maybe I'll do it later, but yeah, all these men were people that she were interested in.
I need my Beckle because he's another awesome brother. I need my sisters too. Where are my sisters? Where are there females on YouTube? There are not many of you guys. Or you guys keep to yourselves. You're like, I don't want to open to that girl. She's brash and... I don't know. I need my brothers. You keep talking about this Christian unity. Like, you ain't unifying with your sister. Now, your sister needs you, Jason. Now, you get in off Nadia. Now, listen to me. You click off Nadia's little hangout. Yes, darling.
I don't have papers.
High five.
So her kids are doing chores and cleaning while her big ass sits there and begs Jason to come online. And this is the very small time you see her interact with her child before Jason actually comes on. And look at how quickly she flips.
Now, is all the like stuff is off the table? Is the table completely bare?
No.
Then make the table completely bare and then wipe it off with a sponge.
And one job?
You have one job right now. I will give you one after you're done with this one.
What the second one is?
I don't know. You're going to earn this money. You're going to earn your chores. Oh, no.
I mean to tell you something.
What do you need to tell me?
I want to save it for Quick Trip.
You want to save it for Quick Trip? Cool.
I'm doing the
What would you get at Quick Trip?
A shake.
A shake? Mm-hmm. Well, they don't have good shakes at Quick Trip. We could go to, like, McDonald's or Burger King or Dairy Queen or Culver's. They're really good shakes.
Carmel!
Oh, my God, it's Jason! Go on to chores now.
How damn Whoa. Pathetic can you be?
Whoa.
Jason, I love you. I miss you.
I want your money, Jason. Give me some money, Jason.
Oh, sir. You take that mute off right now. I've been waiting for your butt for like a year now.
Jenny, I never ignore you. You know that. Come on, honey. I love you.
I love you, too. I miss you, Jason.
Give me that money, Jason.
There, I know Dan writes better.
Yeah, you might want to shut that screen off so he doesn't know exactly what you really look like. So you could use this very filtered picture of you instead. We're on to you,
that
Shannon.
That looks fucking disgusting, though.
I got your attention, anyway.
You got editing software.
Sorry, Jason.
You couldn't make a better picture.
I'm doing fine.
Come
I'm
on
doing
now.
Fine. I'm trying to get Nadia to not want to, kill herself. You know, that's why I haven't been paying attention to others. You know what I mean?
No, she doesn't care that you're trying to help another person not off themselves. She only cares you're not paying attention to her.
Yeah,
don't you understand that? Oh, you will soon, sweetheart. You will soon.
It's rough. You know, you brought me into this G-plus shit, Shani, you know. So, it's on you. You know what I mean? I'm doing my best here.
I know your message is wonderfully beautiful. Sorry, Positive Godless. This is between me and Jason, not you.
Why is it public? Why is it public?
I don't know.
Wow, Scott, just chill out, Scott.
I just came in the room. Like, why is it public?
Yeah, usually open hangouts that are public, anyone can come into. But Shannon is going to throw this man out. Oh, boy.
Because I'm retarded sometimes, that's why.
It's all right. I just came into a public hangout. That was kind of a little mean, Rev. Why do I need to chill out?
Yes, you need to chill. You need to, like...
I'm pretty chill?
Get a cup of tea. Drink it. Relax.
I don't drink tea.
That's why you ain't relaxing.
I don't like tea.
That's why you can't relax.
That makes no sense.
Tea relaxes you, man.
I'm not a big fan of tea. Sorry.
Tea has caffeine in it, so I don't see how it would possibly calm anyone down, Shannon.
Oh, well then, get out of my room. No, I'm kidding.
Wow.
Anyway. I want Jason.
You want me to leave this hangout?
Yes.
Okay. You have a Minnesota accent, Ember. Why do you have a fake accent? I was just kind of curious.
And Scott calls her out for the fake, phony-ass Southern accent. That Southern accent. She's from Minnesota.
No, don't do it.
My accent. I don't know what my accent is, actually. It goes in and out. I'm from the South, but yet I lived in Minnesota, so it, like, goes on and off.
That's such a crock of shit, Shannon, and you just realized that you got called out, and you must feel pretty stupid, because I lived in the South, too. It's funny I didn't pick up an accent, you liar.
Yeah.
So, if this is between you and
yes.
Jason, wouldn't you take this off air? Why is this live?
good question, Scott.
I swear, you... what is with children always trying to distract me when they're trying to do chores? They're like, I don't want to do chores. Other than that, they just completely ignore me. No. What was that you said? Sorry.
Oh, I'm just curious why this is live.
Wait, why are you distracting me? I'm trying to talk to Jason.
Well, one, you made it a public hangout. Two, it's live. I'm just asking you questions. Second, I'm just never really talked to you before, so.
What is the question?
You don't want to talk.
Okay, you addressed the first one, I think, because you made it public, so that's fine. But then it's live. Why is it live?
Because I was calling him out. I wanted to get his attention.
You got it.
You got it, yeah. Can I hang with you guys? Is that cool?
Doesn't sound like it's cool, absolutely. Scott. I don't think they're going to go for it. I'm cheering for you, though. I'm secretly cheering for you.
So calling out Reb News J.
Right.
Why, Shani? Why?
Come on, do it. Get that. Yeah.
Because she wanted your attention, Jason, because she wants your money. Wake up. You won't know this for a few years, but you're being played, and you're going to lose everything that you have.
Now that that money's gone, he knows.
They're still waiting for her to come into the
admin,
room,
like,
by the way.
For the hangout, is that okay?
Absolutely. Give it to him.
Thanks.
Whoa, Shani left. All right.
Oh, there we go. I think she was calling out, like, a bunch of her friends, so... she may be back. She may be tending to her kids right now, so...
Oh, no, Scott, I don't think she's tending to her children at all. I think her husband probably came home, or she's screaming at her children for not doing the chores that she wouldn't do herself. That's what I actually think's happening.
Well, I saw my username in the Hangout, so I had to jump in.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
Oh, absolutely. Oh, she's back.
Welcome, admin.
Hello, admin.
I didn't join until after you said that I could.
Yeah, I just figured I might as well get permission since this isn't really my room, so.
Most likely she won't be coming back.
Why?
Probably because she was trying to hold a Rev.
Well, she did, and I did ask. I mean, you know, is that cool if I stay in the room? Rev said it was okay. She didn't really give an answer.
You didn't. I'll give you that, Scott. I'll give you that. You did ask a logical question. If she's trying to call him out, why did she keep her on air?
Right. I really don't like to start anything. Most people know that's not my personality, so.
Well, admin, listen, bro. You know, I saw the title of the Hangout calling out Reb News J, so here I am. You know, what the...
I mean, yeah, I understand. I mean, people don't call me out, so, yeah, even if they did, I would vibe that with my girlfriend afterward, and then come home exhausted and only get about 6 to 3 hours of sleep before I go out and do it again.
That sounds like a good life, actually.
Yeah, praise the Lord, huh?
Amen.
I'll just keep quiet on that one, so.
Yeah, well, you can praise God inside, that's okay, because we both know it's true.
No, but that wasn't the conversation I was going to get into, but that's all right.
Scott,
God, this is uncomfortable. Thank God I wasn't around for Hangouts. This video is about 7 years old, and it's extremely awkward right now.
Both know you have doubts inside about being an atheist. It's okay.
Listen, you know, this is fucking bizarre. Where is Shani?
I have no idea.
It's really weird.
Now you need to call her out.
No, I won't do that.
Yeah, I need to call her out, Rev.
I was just joking, of course.
Not going to
do a brother in Christ.
Did you send her a message saying, where's go?
And Scott, I just see my name in a Hangout. I'm like, what's happening here? Hey, Deidre.
Hey, Deidre.
Hey, Deidre.
Hey, I just came in to tell Shani in our Hangout. Stop being dumb. Stop being dumb. It's a choice. It's a choice. Stop being. What's going on?
Well, she now left, so I don't know why.
She left. What's the matter?
Oh, there she is. There she is. Hey, Shani.
All right, so you're calling me out, Shani. Why? What's up?
Nothing. I wanted to get a hold of you, and I wanted your attention, and I was being kind of funny and cute at the same time while being kind of dramatic, because everyone thinks I'm dramatic, and I'm really not. Does that make any sense? And my sons are driving me nuts. Yes, dear. No. Clean the table, like I told you. Thank you. Okay, anyway. But I was going to take this off air as soon as I got a hold of you. because I don't want to embarrass you that much. Just want to call you out.
So she made a hangout called Calling Out Revelation News, but she didn't want to embarrass him. But she made it public and just talked about how he's ignored her this whole time. This whole thing was cringy as hell, and that's the whole video. I have another video for you guys that's much more in depth. And we talk a lot about her mom. We see her mom loving on her.
Ella,
what she told you was a bunch of bullshit, and I can't wait to get into all of that, but that's a much longer video, and I didn't have all that time to do that. But I hope everyone had a wonderful Father's Day yesterday, and I really appreciate the person who super chatted me. Thank you so much.
Ella is a great lady. You guys, you guys need to check her out. Her channel's awesome. Let's see what else we can react to. Let's watch. This is called Channy for Christ and Love from Dumpster Clips. It's a short one, but... Shouting out dumpster clips.
Oh my God, Kevin.
This is from that channel.
Oh, no.
This is tied to them.
He
dumpster clips.
No, no.
No, honey, Gavin's okay.
No, no, no.
Is Gavin okay? Honey, you need to get back on the highway.
Look how sweet.
I wanted to check on him.
Can we go park somewhere so we're not like in the middle of traffic? Can you fucking use your fucking head and get off the side of the goddamn road and go down and park somewhere smart?
Shut the fuck up. If he's okay, I can get back on. No problem. Cat on your lap, you fucking idiot.
What the fuck?
If he's on that floor again, you are getting your ass beat. Do you hear me?
What?
Wow.
Oh, piece of shit.
Jason William Egroff, stop this.
No, I won't. You're not a mother.
Damn.
Say anything. I'm so fucking sick of it.
I literally was saying something.
I'm sick of it.
Yeah, well, you
I'm trying to pull over to see if the cat's alive.
Deal with it,
yeah, well, I don't want to be killed in traffic because you're stupid.
Not stupid, you fucking moron. That's what it's for, the side of the fucking highway.
Yeah,
why would
right
you
at
do that to an autistic child? Any child, but an autistic child? Come on, you guys.
That kid will not listen to a word any of you say, including me.
He has some issues, Rev, you dumbass.
told him to put him on his lap a long time ago and he wasn't doing it. The hell do you want? You gotta start being more fucking assertive, man.
Yeah.
I can't believe Shanny had
you. If you come near me like that again, you talk to me like that.
I'm tired of having a woman that treats me this way. I'm sick of it.
Look how you're treating me.
I am sick
of
it.
Look how he treats me. What about the kids? Exactly. What about the
honey,
child?
I wouldn't be acting like this if you're not
shut up.
Screaming and treating people like shit.
Fuck off and shut
hey,
up.
How about you fuck off and shut up?
I wish I could.
What is wrong with you?
I'm sick of being fucking disrespected.
Can you be happy for once? You're not being disrespected.
I'm constantly.
You're disrespecting me.
You.
You're disrespecting me. Disrespecting you.
What happened? I pulled over in a place that I should to check on the fucking cat. You called me an idiot.
How, or
I'm
not
sick
how,
of it.
But any videos?
It's an idiotic thing to pull off in the side of the road like that.
I cannot believe he did that to that kid.
That cat better fully be on your lap. Pull him all the way up now.
Hey, quit being a jackass.
Now, pull
wow.
him up. I'm not kidding you. The whole thing.
Wow.
No, he's not fully on your lap.
And then doing this on live.
Oh.
Thank you.
Remember,
thank you.
Dumpster clips.
No, I didn't call the kids fucking idiot. Call Revit.
Yeah.
Shut up, Rev. You are an idiot.
Sympathy. This will come as no shock to anyone that knows Shanny, but for those of you who don't know, here's a quick recap. See, Shanny has had a long history of child abuse and neglect. Shanny has two children from a previous marriage. For years, Shanny exposed them to horrible, horrible things that they should have never heard or seen. She's been noted to have body slammed one of them. Rev
what?
Even said this. Rev said that Shanny picked one of the boys up and body slammed them one day. She
oh
let them
God.
Live in squalor, she'd only feed them minimal amounts of fast food, and when CPS finally found out about this, and they only found out about this because Rev went to jail for beating one of them, CPS
yeah.
saw the squalid conditions that she had the children living in, saw the state of the kids who were noted as being malnourished, and they were taken away promptly,
really?
As they should have been. Well, Jason beat
ass.
One of the boys over a disagreement about a movie. See, Shannon played it off like
ass.
She was going to do everything she could get her kids back, and this was all Jason's fault. This was all Rev's fault, that he was the reason that her kids were taken away and she had nothing to do with it. Well, she ended up taking Rev back, and that
what?
Basically sealed the fate of her kids
oh, yeah.
being
okay,
wards of the state,
that.
Which I am all for. I am rarely in a situation where I am like, the state should take a child, but this is one of those situations. Shanny is no mother. She let those kids suffer and suffer all under the guise that she loved them. She never loved them. She used them. And she was upset that she had lost two tools that she could use to get people to do things for her. Oh, please help me. I have two boys. Don't let me be all cold on the street. Just donate. We have two boys. She'd use them for donations. She'd use them for sympathy. She'd even make them come on camera sometimes to
what?
Defend her against the internet bullies and trolls. Shanny and Rev both abused those children. Not only that, but they also abuse each other. Rev will call Shanny every name under the sun. Probably all of those are deserved. And Shanny will physically abuse Rev because I don't know if you can tell, but there's a clear size difference going on here. Hell, Shanny's even gone away in cuffs for beating Rev. But somehow through all this, they're still together. And I think it's because they know that no other human being on this earth wants their absolutely vile personality in their life. And that leads us to today, where you see these two in this picture right now. See, after blowing through all of Jason's inheritance on just giving people money, giving people houses, spending it all on consoles that you wouldn't even need, multiple PlayStation 5s, multiple Nintendo Switches, tons of fast food, just tons and tons of garbage, 700 grand worth of garbage they spent this all on. They don't have a penny left. See this couch that they're sitting on right here? This is Rev's uncle's house. They are down so bad that they are living with Rev's uncle. They refuse to get a job. They sat around all day e-begging, and I mean hardcore e-begging. Mm-hmm. Please give us money. And now they've come up with a new ploy, because I'm assuming it must have got them a bunch of food the first time. Their new scheme is for Shanny to fake that she has cancer, to continue to say that she's going to get a mammogram.
I told Tommy I need to get an MRI.
And then say that she's not going to get a mammogram.
I never said I was going to get my mammogram.
All the strings to make this crime happen. And over time...
And I don't want to talk about it right now.
See, all of these illnesses that you're going to hear Shanny mention in these next couple videos I'll show you, none of them have been diagnosed. She's just massively overweight. That's where all of her physical ailments come from. It's not cancer. It's not MS. It's not fibromyalgia. She's been diagnosed with none of these things. Keep all this in mind, folks, as I take you back to 2019, where her first documented case of a cancer claim comes from.
I guess you got your wish, Blue, like...
Holy shit, look at her face.
All those times you said, I hope you get cancer and die.
Look at, she's a lot skinnier. Holy shit.
I'm not that facing that reality.
I'm saying. Look at her face.
So I'm going to do you a favor, Blue. I'm going to let you watch me suffer and die so you can feel better about such a wonderful human being you are for wishing that upon someone just to see them go through it. I hope it gives you joy and satisfaction. I hope it gives you some twisted form of justice in your head so you get your wish. You get your wish. You get to see me die.
3.5 years ago, she made this claim. She hasn't talked about specialists that she's gone to see. She hasn't talked about surgeries or treatments that she's done in that time. She's talked about none of it. The only times that Shanny would bring up her MS and her cancer was either when she wanted to get out of doing something or she was trying to defend herself. She was saying all of this not only in front of Rev, whose mother died of cancer. He watched his mother slowly die of cancer in front of his eyes. But she's saying this in front of her children who were still with her at the time, who think that their mother is extremely sick and don't know what they're going to do when they're left alone in this world with Rev, who's extremely mean to them. The kids had to have been feeling this way for years because this next clip that I'm about to show you is from 2021, where she lists out all of her supposed illnesses to defend herself from the trolls.
I am a woman who is suffering from breast cancer, MS, fibromyalgia.
Kind of crazy how a woman with breast cancer, MS, and fibromyalgia can get arrested for beating her husband who has no reported illnesses. Sure, he's tiny. I mean, just ask about baby carrot down in the comments below. But that still doesn't explain to me how you got up in such immense pain and managed to lay hands on Jason. Not only that, but move a car, which contained all of your snacks and food, off of a railroad track in a display of Hulk-like strength.
Try to go over them. Oh, God.
Oh,
no.
Cool.
That's it.
No. We're wrecked.
Oh, fuck.
No.
That's it.
We're wrecked.
Jason?
What?
Call the cops.
Yeah, we're calling the cops.
It's on the run, kid.
Oh my God, she's fucking badass.
I find it a little odd, Shannon, that you, with all of your fibro and all of your MS, could get up and lift a car off of the railroad tracks to save your snacks. Because I know you didn't do it for Jason. I know you didn't do it for them boys. You did it for that good, that Fig Newton. Truly a miracle from a woman who is so addled with sickness. But guys, if she's been sick for so long, surely things have gotten worse. Let's hop forward in time to Christmas 2022, when the cancer claims of this day really started ramping up.
I told Tommy, I need to get my mammogram, I need to get an MRI, and then I also need to get the surgery for the fucking... Like, stop coming to me over
that. I didn't truly believe that you have cancer. I don't know what you don't understand here, Shani. I think that you're scared. I think that you know that the district attorney knows about your little scam, and you're trying to backpedal it. This has Jason shook as well. You can see him in the background. I think that he knows deep in his heart that she doesn't have anything going on with her. This is all a scam for donations. But you can see him there in the back. He's like, let's move on. This is ridiculous. I don't think he wants to do this. He saw his mother die of cancer, and now Shani is here, for years been saying that she has cancer, all undiagnosed, all to try to get sympathy, views, and donations. Absolutely disgusting.
Like, what do you guys think about this shit? That they're sending fucking shit to prosecutors and stuff over my own personal health?
Fucking nuts.
I'm telling you, they're doing this on purpose because they want a case to get started so they can look at my fucking medical files.
Probably. Yeah, that makes sense.
It's a fucking scam.
To get FOIA on your medical files?
But go ahead. Go ahead and keep reporting stupid false reports. Because someone's talking about their fucking body and the shit that's going on with them.
No.
There's no case to that. They never asked for money for that. They're harassing you to make money off of you.
Yeah,
exactly.
Well, yeah, that's
accurate. Tell that person to give you money.
Exactly.
But, like, we wouldn't even talk about this ever if it wasn't brought to the chat. That's the thing.
Yeah.
We'd be doing our own thing watching videos. Like, we can't let that take the steam, Shani. You know what I mean?
But they need, I do believe, because I've seen it on numerous channels, but they need actual proof. You spray say you want donos for, you never say cancer fund. Yeah, exactly.
Here, Jason's subtly hinting to Shani, hey, we can't let your cancer take center stage of the stream. You know, it's just something people keep bringing up in chat. And Shani's like, yeah, you know, I'm suffering from cancer and fibromyalgia and MS. She's basically saying that every other 5 minutes, all while that donation link is right there. And, you know, they would just really appreciate the help, guys. Shannon, I know Rev is a piece of shit, but haven't you abused him enough? Look at this picture. She caught him messaging, not even meeting up with, because there's no way that they could afford the prostitutes that he was messaging. So he was caught messaging prostitutes. Shani made him shave his own head, paint the letter A on his forehead. He had to wait for his hair to grow back out. He couldn't shave it completely bald, no. He had to keep it like that until it grew back out. Shannon, I feel like you just have this thing for abusing people. It makes you happy to hurt other people. You did it with your boys. You're doing it with Jason. And now you're trying to do it to anybody who will donate to you. You're trying to trick them when maybe, just maybe, they think that they're doing something good, that they're helping somebody out who is suffering from a very serious illness.
Let's see what else we could. Let me go back to Ella.
find out later on.
Let's see. Let's do this one.
Two schmucks out, because that's what I'm gonna do.
It's caught in the crowd.
I saw it and it extremely aggravated me, so I'm gonna talk about it. Let's watch.
Hey guys, how you doing? I'm not even gonna wait for people to come in. I'm just gonna have this be here
you
so that you can see
Shani
it.
Files
so I'm asking for prayer again for Shani because she's just in massive pain. It doesn't seem to be getting any better.
No, and it's never going to get better until she loses 500 pounds.
Or anything like that. So that's just a continued prayer request to keep Shani in your prayers for healing and all that good stuff.
Yep, I pray for her every day and every night. I'm always praying for Shani all the time, every time.
But we've been without the EBT for quite a while now.
He's a liar.
And I haven't done this in a long time, but it really is needed. Anything that you guys could help out with in terms
he's
of money for food,
EBT.
We'd really appreciate it.
Why does it have to be money? Why can't people just send you food if you need food so bad? Because I don't believe it's for food. I don't believe your EBT bullshit story either. I think that you want money for Delta 8. That's what
I think.
And we should be getting our food stamps soon, but we're pretty short right now. So if you want to give anything, you could PayPal me at
Rev couldn't stop you right there. Because I'm not going to promote your PayPal. If you want to donate to anything worth a shit, I'm running a charity called Bags of Love. It's for homeless women who have nothing, literally nothing, not even a roof over their head. I am doing that. If you would like to help, instead of giving these idiots a dime because it's just going to go somewhere else, please donate it to Ballerina81 on Cash App, and I will put it right towards the charity. Do that instead of sending them money, because they don't need your money. But the women on the streets do. They actually do. And I've had some amazing people reach out to me and amazing people donate to me. And I'm very, very, very lucky to have such amazing people around me to help me with this. If you would like to help me with this instead of helping these two schmucks out, because that's what I'm going to do with this, is shamelessly plug my charity. And hope to God you donate to me before you ever donate to them, because I'm actually going to do something good with the money instead of just using people on the internet to take care of my life.
Exactly.
I can take care of my own life. I don't need to e-bag like these two. But this is pathetic. It infuriates me. And working in a charity makes me just a little bit more sensitive to shit like this. So money sign Ballerina81. It will go straight to the charity. You will get a receipt of what it purchased, and that will be that. I'm done listening to these two idiots beg. I'm done. I'm over it. Get a life. Get some help. Oh, God. I'm so frustrated.
At Revit. You know, the app thing, and then it's
Cash App Ballerina81.
That's my PayPal, and if you could give anything for food, we'd really appreciate it. Other than that, that's it. That's really all I wanted to say.
Of course it's
I hope everybody's doing okay. But yeah, Shani's just been in continuing pain, and it just keeps getting worse. And she's on medication for it. She's going to the doctor, doing everything she's supposed to do.
Perfect. Is she seeing a bariatric doctor? Is she seeing anyone about her weight? Because her pain levels will come down immensely if she did that.
It's too much, you know? The pain is just too much.
Shani doesn't even know pain. Shani has no idea what pain even is. Shannon should meet my mom, and then she could talk about pain.
Exactly, Ella. I've been praying for your mom, by the way, dear.
Yeah. God bless you. And again, like, donations would be not, they're really needed right now. So if you would like to give something, we...
If you'd like to give something, you can give it to money sign ballerina 81. That's my Cash App for my charity. Thank you.
I'd appreciate that. The PayPal is at
Cash App ballerina 81. Thank you.
Guys, actually thank not you. A scammer.
Oh, I'm not concerned in the least bit. Just to give you a little, you know, reminder of who you'd be sending that money to if you did decide to send these people a nickel, let's just take a look at where that money would be going and who these people are. Because I'm running a charity, my P.O. Box is 49 West Jericho Turnpike, Commack, New York, 11725, number 1037. That's my P.O. Box. That's where you can send any charity-related supplies. Anyway, I'm using this to just promote my charity, but let's see what losers these people are, shall we?
We got nipples, you know, like, it's not allowed, whatever. I got my abs showing. You see these abs starting to pop out? That's pretty awesome.
Nope.
So it's Rev, you know, you get Reverend Dude here. And, hey, Dragnaut, why don't you take a look at the title of this video? Take a look at the title of this video. That's what I just made my wife do. What did you do to your wife? Nothing, because you're a disgusting fucking sack of shit that R.S. aid his wife at 14 in a theater and got away with it. You're a fucking sack of shit, dude.
That never happened, by the way. That never, ever, ever happened.
Like, I'm sorry. You have this channel where you can criticize everyone. Well, I'm going to critique you. You're not, I mean, you called your kid a waterhead or whatever. Like, give me a break, dude. And you try to be a pillar.
You kicked your child in the head and in the stomach. I'm sorry, not your child. Not even your child. You did that too.
Virtue. Okay. You know you're a sack of shit, man. So you get the Reverend Dude tonight. Yeah, I made my wife squirt. Dragnaut, how do you like that?
No, you didn't, Rev. You couldn't make a lemon squirt.
S-Q-U-I-R-T.
Oh, my God.
Isn't he a gem, kids? Anyway, like I said, shameless plug, please, 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 if you're going to donate to them, donate to my charity instead. Bags of Love, Cash App, Ballerina 81. And that is all I have to say this mess. Love you guys. Bye.
We love you, Ella. Okay, what would you guys, let's see, actually, I think that's enough, but you guys can think of anything else you would like me to react to. I just didn't have nothing else to do tonight, so take care, you guys.